when do you go for the page block table, when do you go for the data table. Boss, it's purely UI, you're optional based on the UI. You want to go with a standard layout what Salesforce is giving you, then we go for page block table. No, I want to apply my own rules, then I'll go for data table. Let me give an example here. If I click on home, now look at this. Now here I cannot go with a data, page block table. They are also displaying what? List of records. They are also displaying what? List of record. But I don't want to go with a standard layout because the layout is not standard. The layout is not standard. I was supposed to apply my own layout. Now if I go to the leads, now what was this? Here, we want the UI to be in this format. Now what is this? Standard layout. I will go with the page block table. So it depends upon what format of UI you are looking for. Based on that, you are supposed to create this. Right, boss? Okay. Now let us go back to the data table. First, let me show you the attributes. We have rules, we have borders. What are the different attributes what we have? Right. Align. Align the content with respect to the page. Background color, border, caption class, caption style, in case we are going with a caption, cell spacing, cell padding, columns, and if you are going for a column, you want to apply any CSS, wherever you are finding classes here, that is a CSS, column width, direction, first, footer class, this is CSS again, frame, header, then you can go with rendered, row class, number of rows, rules, style, rules will specify groups, rows, column, how you want to get the lines. Okay. So with the help of these, let me create some of the examples. Going with the standard controller. Account. What I was supposed to give? Record set where. Now what is this record set where? It is a variable which is having a list of records which are fetched based on the filter what we have given. There in the object we have filter. All records, this week records, last week records. Based on that filter, whatever the records we fetched that are referred with this record set where. Now we are going with first point. When you take a page block table should be a child of page block. But data table is not a child of page block. You want to write within a page block, it's your choice. But data table is not a child of page block. Page block table is a child of page block table is a child of page block. Page block table is a child of page block. Now we are giving value equal to first one. What is the purpose of this data table? This component is used display list of records. List of records are displayed in the form of this will not inherit the standard look and feel. Salesforce. Next, when you are going with this, attributes, what is the value? This will contain list of records which you want to display. Where this is a variable. Referring to one by one record, then we are going with apex column value equal to A dot name, apex column value equal to A dot industry, value equal to A dot. If I give apex data table, you will not be getting borders, you will not be getting header values. Look at this. Are you getting any header value? There is no header value. To get a proper look, let me give some BRs so that we identify the data. Now, are we getting any header values? The next one, it is not giving you the proper alignment of the data because the width is not mentioned. Based on the size of the data in the column, length of the column is defined. The length of the column is defined based on the size of the data. Now, here I am giving ln RTL. What is it, ln RTL? Right to left. If I want to say right to left, first you have to specify the width of this. You have to specify the width of this. So what I am going to do here? Before we align, we are taking width equal to 500. When you say width equal to 500, the width of the box, right now they are compressed. Data is compressed. Now we want the data to be, now right now the data is compressed. We are, okay, increasing the size of the table. We are increasing the size of the table. Basically, when you go to a page block table, automatically it will align based on the width of the page what is available. In the page block table, I didn't mention any width. Automatically, it is auto-adjusted towards the size of the page. Depends upon the available width, page block table is automatically aligned. But here, the data is going to be compressed. We need to apply the width to increase the size of the table. Then here we have border 2 pixel. You told border equal to 2 pixel. So what happened here? So we got the border. When I say border, it is aligning rows, columns, horizontal, verticals. Now when you say border, this rows is separate, columns is separate, horizontal is separate, and your verticals are separate. Horizontal, vertical, row wise, column wise, all options are coming here. Border. So, what are the two attributes we have here? Go to the data table. Thank you. The same story, I'm taking one more exam. Now, insta of border, I want to give cell padding. Now, if you don't give the border, the cell padding will not be visible here. What I was giving here, cell padding. Cell padding. Now, what was the cell padding what we are giving? Here, if you look at this, data is coming from this corner. Right. But now, there is a space here. There is a space here, there is a space here. Now, you are finding a gap here, right? This is called cell padding. Cell padding. When I say cell padding, this is the page. The page. This is the page what we had. In the page, I am printing a component here. Actually, this is what? This point is 0, 0. Now, whatever the gap you are giving here, it is a margin. In the CSS, we call it as left margin. We have top margin, bottom margin, if you want to give any margins on. These are called margins. These are called margins. Left margin, top margin, bottom, right. Now, similarly, in this, if we print any data, this will be printed here. This is how the data has to be printed. Now, I don't want to print the data like this. Or else, like, within this, I don't want to print from here. I want to print from here. Now, this is the element. This is the element which I want to print. This is the page. This is the page. This is the element what I want to print. In this element, from where the data should be printed. That is your padding. So, what we call? This is called left padding, top padding. This is left padding, top padding. This is what is called padding. So, where the element should be printed, there is a margin. In the element from where the data should be printed, it is a padding. Okay. Now, when you are printing, next line I want to print. Now, this gap is called cell spacing. This space what you are finding, it is called cell spacing. So, what we have? Margin, cell padding, cell spacing. Margin, cell padding, cell spacing. Margin is from the page where the element should be printed is the margin. In the element from where the data should be printed is the spacing. Okay, gap between element to element is gap between element to element is spacing. Okay, in the element from where the data should be printed is a padding. So we have margin, cell padding, cell spacing. Right now, if you look at this example, we are gave cell padding. When you say cell padding, from where the this gap we got here previously, what is that? Now it is printed from here. Now, in the same one, we are going with the next. Cell padding, cell spacing. Now, you are finding the gaps here. these gaps you are finding because of cell spacing, cell padding, cell spacing. I hope you are good with this. Now this is how we got. I removed that. Now let us go to the next one. Now look at this, not given, not applied here. There's a margin left. Now we got the gap here. This is a margin left. I want some space to be on the top. We can also give margin. There. Now, everything is printed from the top corner here, 0. You can observe here, everything is printed from the top corner. But here I told, left margin. Then this is a spacing and this is padding. Right, boss? So what we have? If you want to apply any additional styles, we can go with this. If you want to apply any additional styles, we can go with this. Right, boss? Okay. Now, we can also give here. Color we give red and we are giving try just trying to understand the properties. Apply it, it's okay. Okay, let us go to the next one, rows and frames. Next, we have one more attribute here called rows and frames. What is that row?
Can you apply the style on the column level?
We can apply it. Now, let us go to next. Let us go to the next one. We are want to understand rules, and we want to apply frames also. We want to apply rules and we want to apply frame. Somewhere it will be on the top. Rules and frames. Let us take this. Same story I am taking it. Now this flexibility is not available. This flexibility is not available for you on page block table. Page block table will give you fixed structure. But here you have a choice to manage as per your requirement. But it is a table. It is a table. You can manage it as per your requirement. So I have frame. I told frame, box. Now if you look at this, it is a box. Frame, box. We are simply getting a box, right? Now we want to say frame, rows and columns. So if you look at this, only height sides, only horizontal size, right? Now the frame says what format of data? We have only head sides, vertical sides, left hand side, only left hand side, only right hand side, you got the corresponding. So frame will define where you want the border element should be given for only left side or right side or verticals, all horizontals or all horizontals or all verticals or all box. So what was the element here we have taken? So let us take this. Possible values are box.
Satish, just a query that Apex data table is also kind of written under Apex form. That means all the form elements like checkboxes, buttons, hyperlinking, that all be possible to bring it.
Everything that you are able to display, everything that you are able to display with the page block table, that will come with a data. Only difference is UI. There you are getting a proper standard UI. Here you need to organize the UI. That's only the difference. What can be achieved, what can be achieved, what cannot be achieved is exactly what page block table is doing. There is no difference between page block table and data table apart from UI. Apart from UI. I hope you are good with this.
Yeah, I understand that, you know, it depends on the requirement, what your requirement is, whether you want more customization or not. But in your experience or opinion, how many times, I mean, people actually go for the data table than the page block table?
I repeat the same answer.
Okay, that depends on the requirement. Okay.
Now I have rules. Grouping of elements, possible values, rows and columns. Now, while practicing your programs, don't use page block table, use a data table or repeat so that you get control on the UI. You get a control on the UI. Otherwise, when you are going with a page block table only, you don't apply any CSS or styles, then designing your UI will become difficult for you in the coming classes. So when you are practicing any tables, do practice with a repeat or data table only. Because when you're going for a page block table, you get a standard look and feel. Then you will not apply any one of your own styles. You don't try to improvise your UI levels, UI of your pages. So please do practice only on data table and repeat. As per the requirement, if you get a page block table, you can do it. But while you are learning the course, you are supposed to not to use a page block table. Practice with the data table and repeat. The reason is, it will help you to improve the design of the pages. It will help you to, practice the CSS on the UI levels. Right? So do practice only data table and repeat. Don't display the data with the page block table. In class, I may use page block table to complete the example quicker. But you are supposed to practice with the data table and repeat so that you get control on CSS. Right, boss? Okay. Now let us go back to the next one. I hope you have seen the data table. Now, how many records can be displayed? Same story. 1,000 records can be displayed. Then we have next element, repeat. Repeat. This is also one of the element what we have to display a group of records. Repeat. The advantage of this repeat is it doesn't have any structure. It is not a table, don't have any proper UI. It is purely generic. Now, as per your requirement, you design it. There is no limitation on this. There is no structural limitation. When you say data table, it's a table. At the end of the game, the UI you are not getting a proper way, but it's a table. Rows and columns are there. But this doesn't have any structure. You need to form your structure as per your requirement, because the repeat will simply display the data in the sequential order. So let me show you a quick example here. This is one of the strongest tool, because if you want to generate any data in the form of PDF, I want to generate the VF page in the form of PDF. Then standard Visual Force components are not supported on PDF. When I am converting the page in the form of PDF, your page block table, data table, they will not be converted into PDF format. Then you will not be getting the look and feel. Whatever the look and feel we are getting in the VF page, that will not be coming on the PDF. There, if you use a repeat, we take the combination of HTML and repeat and get the same look and feel what we are getting in the VF page. If you use the repeat, whatever the look and feel we are getting on the VF page, same look and feel will come on the PDF also. So if you are generating any VF page as a PDF, like invoice page, I want to generate an invoice page and send an email. I want to generate a Visual Force page, which is an invoice page or order page. I want to send a PDF. Then if you apply a page block table, data table, the look will not come on PDF. There we need to go for repeat only. Are you getting my point here? So repeat, everything is designed by us. Every style we are applying, every structure we are applying in the repeat is designed by the developer. When you go with a page block table, data table, they already have a structures. We are improvising the structure, that's all. But in the repeat, no structure. You need to organize everything as per your choice. Look at this standard controller. Am I audible? Online people, am I audible?
Yes, now it's kind of clear, but it's kind of lagging, just goes away.
Fine, okay. Now we are going with repeat. Apex, repeat. Same story. Var equal to. Then I'm giving. It is not a table. If it is a table, I will go with a column. But it is not a table. So what we have? A. Now, name, have a preview how the data is coming. Sequentially, the data is coming. Now you break the data as per your choice. It is not having any structure. Sequentially, data is printed. Just it's a loop running sequentially. Now you break the data as per your choice. I don't have a proper structure. You organize this data as per your requirement. So let us take repeat. It will display a group of records in the sequential order. Now I'll go with this. Look at the point. Table. I give a table. In the table, what we have? TR. Table TR. In the TR, we have TR stands for row. Name. I have created a table TR TD. I created one row. Look at this. I got the table. Now, let me give you. This is the structure what we receive. Table. Now look at the structure. We are going with TR. TR. Then, okay, I'll repeat. Apex, repeat, value equal to. Var equal to A. In the repeat, I am giving TR. Width. Then, I am giving a TD. A dot name. And TD A dot list. Have a preview. So what is that? Now we are organizing the data in the form of a table. So we can give to go with applying the style on the rows. Basically, we need to apply some styles. I'll go with here style so what we are doing we are taking the help of 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 the HTML and breaking that data into tables here, breaking the data into tables. So we are organizing the data because we are breaking them into rows and columns as per our choice. We are applying some HTML elements and designing as per your requirement. We are applying some HTML elements and breaking them into our requirement. Breaking them into our requirement. Are you getting my point here? Are you getting my point here? Are you getting my point here? So what we are doing here? So, repeat. Every time this repeats, one TR will be formed. What is this TR? What is this TR? What is the TR? Here is one row. Here is one row. So, every time the repeat runs, every time the repeat runs, there are 10 records, 10 TRs will be displayed. 10 TRs will be displayed. The style is not getting applied here. Okay, no issue. Now, every time the repeat runs, one TR will be created. TR is one row. In the row, we have TD, A dot name, A dot phone, A dot industry. I hope you are good with this. So, if you can apply the CSS, still this can be organized in the better way. Now, I just took a basic level of table. Basic level of table I have taken. I have taken a basic level of table. You still apply. If you still apply proper CSS, you get the proper labels here, right? Let me give you. Border. Yeah. No, you got it? Okay. Or we need to apply the padding on column wise. We need to apply the padding on column wise. Okay. Right, boss? So basic structure we received. What was the purpose of repeat? Repeat will break the data into sequential order. Whatever the data we got, it will be sequential order. What we are supposed to do? Apply your own CSS and get the proper look and feel as per your requirement. Because it has no limitation. You can organize the data as per your requirement. We can organize the data as per your requirement. Are you getting my point here? Am I clear? So what is the purpose of repeat? It will display the data row-wise. It will display the data sequentially. Now what you are supposed to do? Break them as per your requirement. Whatever the data we got, that is displayed sequentially. As per your requirement, we can break it and display it. Right? We need to apply a lot of CSS as per your requirement. Right? Now, what is the advantage of this repeat? Anything that we are designing with repeat, if you convert in the form of PDF also, same structure will come. But if you apply a page block table and data table, if I convert into PDF, you will not get the same structure. The UI will be different there. Again, we are supposed to organize it. Are you getting my point? Am I clear? Okay. So last one we have is a data list. We have a page block table, data table, and a repeat. Last one is repeat. Same story again. Standard controller. Value equal to here we are giving a dot name. Data list. It is also not a table. So when you say data list, list of records are displayed. It will display like a list of record. Now what you are finding here is a list of record. What you are finding here, it is a list of record. What you are finding here is a list of record. Here the data is displayed like a list of record. Here the data is displayed like a list of record. Data is displayed like a list of records. Data is displayed like a list of records. Data list, list of records. Data will be displayed in the form of list. Page block table, data table, it is in the form of table. Data list, list wise display. Repeat sequential. Which is more generic? Repeat is more generic. You want the table structure, but you want to customize it? Data table. Now you want to go with a standard look and feel of a table? You'll go with a page block table. You want a list? Data list. You want to make a generic? You want to customize completely as per your requirement? Then repeat. You want a table, but you want to customize it? Then you go with the data table. You want the standard format of Salesforce table, then we go with the page block table. All these four concepts are used for displaying a list of records. How many records will be displayed? 1,000 records. Now, if I make read-only equal to true, it will display 10,000 records. If I make a read-only equal to true, it will display 10,000 records. If I give read-only equal to true, 10,000 records will be displayed. Generally, 1,000 records will be displayed. But if I give read-only equal to true, it will display 10,000 records. I hope you are good. But it is in the form of what? Read-only. It is in the form of read-only. Right. What if you want to display in the edit format? Generally, this is a commonly asked question. I want to display more than 1,000 records, but I want in the edit format. Then what we do? Solution is pagination. Solution is what? Pagination. What is that pagination? You are going for a Google boss. I searched for a data table. How many results we received? 28,000 results are coming. That means 28,000 links are coming. But per page, how many they are displaying? Only 10. So we have option of next, 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 or last. What is this concept called? Pagination. Right. Now, what is the advantage of this? What is the advantage of this? The advantage of this is, look at the format. Everyone, try to understand this example. Why someone prefer to go with pagination? Look at this. Any data that is displayed in the VF page, any data that is displayed in the VF page, the data will be stored in view state. We have a cache. We have a cache for the page. Any data is displayed. If you are loading a page, whatever the data that is loaded on the page, that will be stored to a cache memory. What is that cache called? View state. What is that cache called? View state. Any data that you are displaying in the VF page, any data that you are displaying in the VF page, any data that you are displaying in the VF page, that will be internally stored in what? Cache. There will be a cache here. Now, in this cache, data will be stored. The data will be stored. Now, if you are displaying 1,000 records, all the 1,000 records will be in this cache. If all the 1,000 records are in this cache, the size of this cache is only 135 KB. What is the size of this cache? 135 KB. If you are giving more number of records, if you are giving more number of records, the size is occupied. Then you get an exception called view state exception. You get an exception called view state exception. Boss, any data that you are displaying on the VF page, so to show you perfectly, let me quickly give one example. Let me give you one quick example here.
Can we kind of clear this cache while writing the code?
No. Just let me give you a basic example. Now, this is our data. How many records are there? Every record we are displaying, that will be stored to cache. ID, name, phone. You can see every record values are here. So if you are displaying any data in the VF page, the data will be first coming to the cache. From the cache, they will be displayed. If you are getting 1,000 records and displaying, all the 1,000 records will be in the cache. Now it is going to occupy. The limit of this cache is 135 KB only. So if you fetch unwanted data or more number of records, then they will be throwing an exception called view state exception. There is a reason, don't display too many records on the page at a time. Break them into number of pages, display like per page 10 record. When I say per page 10 record, how many records will be there in the view state? 10 records. When you click on next, next 10 records will be fetched. That is how we can stop this. Are you getting? So it is not a good idea to display a larger number of records on the page, as we have an issue of view state exception. What is that view state? It is a cache. Anything that you perform on the VF page, that will be stored to the view state first. Anything that you are displaying on the VF page, that will be stored to the view state. From view state, it will be displayed to the VF. If you make any changes on the VF, that will come to view state. From view state, it will go to server. From server, you are getting any data. From server to view state to VF page. And we have a limit of 135. So if the people ask you how to display more than 10,000 records, yes, you can do it, but it's not a solution, because I told you, technically for an interview sake, they may ask the question, but practically, what is the problem we have? View state exception. Right, boss? So that's all from mine. So we'll continue tomorrow with tab panels.
Sir, can you